Now let's take a look at it and see like what output we will get. So first time when we call this function with test 4, a stack frame gets created with n is equal to 4. So I'm not putting the return address and all, I'm just putting the value of n directly, and we'll be tracing with the minimal text written here in the animation, right? So we have stack frame of test with n is equal to 4 right now. Now since n is 4, let's go to the first line, and this line says if n is greater than 0, you come inside and you print the value of n. So what will happen on output is we will be printing 4. This function's first line will output 4, and then this makes a recursive call. Now the moment recursive call is made, what happens is another stack frame gets created, and we are passing n minus 1. So we are passing n is equal to 3. So that recursive call, we are into this function again with n 3. Now 3 is greater than 0, we'll be printing 3 here, and another recursive call will be made with 2. So 3 is printed, another recursive call with 2 is made. So we are in another recursive call. So there are 3 recursive calls, basically 3 calls that have happened till now. And now we are in a call where n is 2. 2 is greater than 0, so we print 2 first. And then 2 makes a recursive call to 2 minus 1, which is 1. Well, so we are here. When we are into the call with n 1, 1 is greater than 0, we print 1. And we make a recursive call with n0. So 1 is printed, we make a call with test n0. Now when call with n0 is made, what is happening? 0 greater than 0 is not true. So this if condition evaluates to false. After this if, there is no other statement. This is a void function. So it reaches the last curly bracket, and this function's time to return has come. So eventually when return type is not there and return statement is not there, eventually when function reaches the last line of code, it returns. So test with n0 is going to return. Now when n0 is going to return, to call to 0 was made by this function where n was 1, right? So n was 1 here, 1 was printed, then call to 0 was made, and now that call is returning. So if this call returns, it returns to the previous stack frame where n was 1, and in that stack frame we will go and print the value of n. So 1 will be printed once again, right? So in n is equal to 1, 1 printed, it made a recursive call with 0, and it is printing 1 again, and now it reaches the last line, it says okay, I'm done with my work. So stack frame of this also gets cleared from memory, and now we come back to the return address here where n was 2 and we made a recursive call with 2 minus 1, right? So here we come back, and what we do is next we again print the value of n, and in this stack frame the value of n was 2, so we print 2 again, and when 2 is printed we reach the last curly bracket and we return from here. Now what happens, we go back to the previous function where 3 was printed, recursive call to 2 was made, now it will print 3, and this stack also unwinds. Now we come to n is equal to 4, when initially we were called with n 4, we printed 4, we made a recursive call to 3 which has returned now, and n is still 4, so we print 4, and stack frame of this also gets unwinded. So the output of this program is going to be 4, 3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4.